Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines wants to spread a word on the life and sacrifice of Blessed Pedro Calungsod ahead of his canonization in Rome on October 21st. Caroline Howard attended the CBCP's media briefing on the life, mission and martyrdom and miracle of the second Filipino saint, and she filed this report.
On October 21, 2012, the Vatican in Rome will add 7 new names to the list of Catholic saints. Among them, Filipino lay catechist and martyr Blessed Pedro Calungsod. Beatified on March 5, 2000, Calungsod will become the second Filipino saint after San Lorenzo Ruiz.
And to have this second saint, wow, this is like validating or affirming our role as Christians in the change in the world that must happen, no? Change of good overcoming evil.
He became a witness, no? to the Christian faith. Every Filipino should be grateful to God for this, because we have another model that we can imitate, especially in following the Lord, but not only that, in facing the challenges of the present world.
Little is known about Calungsod's beginnings. There are neither records of his birth or baptism, but there are numerous accounts on the Visayan youth who assisted Father Diego Luis de San Vitores, a Jesuit missionary with evangelizing thousands of Chamorros in Guam in 1668, and how he laid down his life in the shores of Tomjon in the name of his faith.
What made him special is that he became a witness, no? To the Christian faith, but not only that, he died for that conviction.
In 1994, the diocesan process began for Calungsod's beatification, followed by efforts to authenticate a major miracle on which to hinge the cause for his sainthood. In March 2003, a doctor with a strong devotion to Calungsod had sought his intercession to help his patient survive and recover from a heart surgery.
According to the experts later on, is that one, she recovered in a very short period of time. Usually a person would recover like weeks, just 48 hours. Mm-hmm. And second, usually if somebody would survive from a Glasgow coma state, there would be deficits as to motor, but she recovered fully. Until now she's alive. So after that, there were like 9 sessions of real investigation. Then again, the result was submitted to Rome. Then 2 levels of investigations again. One was a group of medical doctors, and they decided that indeed it could not be explained. Then the theologians again would come in. Let's say that there could never be an explanation.
On February 18 this year, following theological validation, Pope Benedict XVI gave the go signal for Calungsod's canonization.
This is a visible manifestation of his recognition of the need to have a young person proclaimed as having led a virtuous life, especially since Pope Benedict is very worried. He's really very worried that in 3 or 4 years, 3/4 of the world will no longer know who Christ is.
Every Filipino should be grateful to God for this, because we have another model that we can imitate, especially in following the Lord, but not only that, in facing the challenges of the present world.
De Villa and Mejia say Calungsod's canonization is just the hope people, especially the youth, need to inspire a virtuous life. Caroline Howard, ABS-CBN News.